Hey, it's Sarah with House Copper, and it is in the middle of summer, even though it doesn't look like it here, but we're all excited because it's like, you know, 68 in the middle of July, and my garden is, one of my gardens, both of my gardens are actually in pretty good shape, so I'm going to do how to make a kitchen sink salad today in a copper bowl, because there's some tricks when it comes to the dressings and things like that that I want to talk about. So in the start of this, I guess first we're going to go in the garden, then we'll go in the other garden. It's just going to be kind of fun and exploratory and quick. And, we'll add a dressing and I'll talk a little bit about that with copper and that'll be it. So here we go. A little bit of everything. Then, so purslane is kind of, it doesn't have a lot of flavor and it's actually quite big right now. But I like it because it adds a little texture. It's an old-fashioned herb, really old-fashioned herb. People actually will put this in with ramen. So if you do ramen and you grow purslane, it grows really easily. Some people say, oh, it's a weed. It's a healthy weed. You can eat it. I add that for a little texture. But if you're making noodles, you can add purslane to your noodles. Then we're gonna grab a little bit of kale, which is taking its sweet time growing this year. I just grab a couple of leaves, and I'm sure Hannah, my daughter's gonna want some for her hamster because we have way too many animals and we added a hamster. So once you add a little bit of this, this is my lunch. And I'm not gonna do a ton of kale because it gets really chewy. And then I like to add just a few herbs, but I like to make sure it's ones that you don't really need to cook with. So we're just gonna keep it to basil. So I've got a little bit of basil here, and you don't need a lot of herbs, they'll overpower. And then if you like onion, you could always add onion. And if you wanna add, and I will add a little bit of cilantro. So we got the greens, and now we get to add the pretty stuff. Using borage for a couple of reasons. It tastes like cucumbers, like really faint cucumber, and you can eat the leaves. They look furry, you know, they look kind of soft and furry, but you can eat the leaves, and the flowers just add like a really pretty little color to any salad, and it reseeds itself every year. So that also helps tremendously in terms of not having to always plant it. You can eat bee balm flowers too. So if you see these pink and red flowers, those you can eat the flowers too. My daughter loves the flowers, but I use it for making medicine in the all summer. Actually, I'll have to make some later, and it's a great medicine for sore throats. All right, and then if you want more color and you're lucky, you can add just a tiny bit. Thank you. salad. I will chop this up as I eat it, but I won't eat it in the copper bowl with the knife, because knives will scratch the copper, unless you don't care if you scratch up your copper. It's totally up to you. But I wanted to talk a little bit about dressings. So an oil-based dressing is fine. And even a vinegar-based dressing, I use mostly different red wine, white wine, even tarragon, vinegars, things like that in my salads for my dressing versus something mayonnaise or egg-based. But a word of warning, if you leave the vinegar to sit in the copper, like let's say you mix this up with a dressing right away, like you're just gonna add a dressing to this and you're gonna eat it out of here, or you're gonna mix it in the copper bowl. If you leave anything super vinegary sitting on the copper or mixed with a little water or anything like that, you will find a very thin over, you know, if you leave it sit for, you know, a day or two and you just don't wash it out really well, you'll find a very thin layer of the green verdigris, which is poisonous to eat off of, sitting on top of your copper surface. So you're gonna wanna get that off right away. So either wash it really, really good with soap if you mix any type of dressing in a copper bowl, or get in there right away. And this is when you wanna almost like get that SOS pad out, and it'd scratch your copper, but you're gonna wanna remove that verdigris right away. So that's my biggest tip and trick for making salads in a copper bowl, which I think is always so pretty. But yeah, be careful of your vinegar dressings. Make sure to wash them out and don't leave them sit. But in the meantime, you can mix this up as much as you want. And I always say that if you have a garden or you have access to a farmer's market and you can get the fresh vegetables, do it as much as you can. Here it's a very limited season, so we do it up as much as we possibly can. And my poor husband is subjected to a lot of salads. So anyway, there it is. Very simple, very easy, no cooking really, just eating in copper and preparing food in copper. And thank you for watching. I know you know how to find me, Facebook, Instagram, House Copper. Let me know any thoughts or comments below. I always love to hear from you. And I will see you next time.